BookTube, it's time to wrap up 2015.
I got my ticket for the long way round.
I'm Jen, and I talk about audiobooks. And I want to tell you about 15 books in 2015 that really were standouts to me. Now, you know me, I always have to cheat. So in one case, it's more like an author, and in another case, it's more like three books of the same genre that kind of I've grouped together. So I'm going to start with the Cricket series. This is by Amy A. Bartoll, and it is narrated on audio by Kate Rudd, who does an amazing job with it. It is three books, Under Different Stars, Sea of Stars, and Dark in the Stars. It's all about a girl who is raised in the foster care system in Chicago. She has run away and is evading the authorities so she doesn't get thrown back in. She finds out she's an alien from another planet, and she gets kidnapped and taken there, and all kinds of antics ensue. The dialogue is fabulous, the characters are wonderful, the romance is very sweet, and I will say this about this series. Both of these books, for me, were 5-star. This last one, not so much. I didn't like where the main character went with this book, and I was really disappointed. So I'm hoping that she will write a fourth book to kind of really close out the series and tie up some loose ends. The Pillars of Reality series, this is by Jack Campbell, and it is narrated on audio by McLeod Andrews. This is a series that was written specifically for audio. And it is all about Mari and Elaine, and they live in a world where you have the mechanics who are kind of a steampunk guild, and they don't believe in magic, they believe in science, and then you have the mage guild where they all believe in magic, and they're almost like monks with no emotion. And so Elaine is a mage and Mari is a mechanic. The fourth book in this series is coming out later this year, and I can't wait. Walk on Earth a Stranger, this is by Ray Carson, and it is narrated on audio by Aaron Mallon. I listened to it on audio, and I loved this because it was such a departure from the norm in terms of genres in YA. It's all about the gold rush, and it is wonderful. These next three books are the three that I wanted to group together. They are all adult sci-fi, which I kind of delved into a little bit this year, got a bit of a taste of it. And the first of those books is The Long Way to a Small Angry Planet, and this is by Becky Chambers. It is available on audio, but only in the UK. I read it as an ebook. It's narrated by Patricia Rodriguez, and it's about crew on a spaceship, and they basically mine wormholes, and they have to go on a very long journey. And so it's just basically the story of them on the ship. But it's a really great dynamic between all this cast of characters. The second one is The Book of Strange New Things by Michelle Faber. I never would have expected to love this book. It is narrated on audio by Josh Cohen. And I didn't listen to the audio. I instead read the ebook because I started out with the audio and didn't care for it. This book impacted me in a very personal way with regard to ministry, Christian ministry, and the way it works. And I did a review on the book, so you might want to check that out. I'll link it below. And the last one was Seven Eves, which is the epic story by Neal Stephenson. It is narrated on audio by Mary Robinette Kowal and Will Dameron. I listened to it on audio, and then I bought the book, and then I gave the book away, which was so much fun. This is the story told in essentially three parts. Each part could be their own book, but see, this is the difference between YA and adult sci-fi. Adult sci-fi puts it all in one book instead of three. It's the story of the moon exploding and then everybody coping with that in space because the whole surface of the earth gets burned off. And then the third part of the book is 5,000 years later. 5-star book. Epic, epic story, and I absolutely loved it, and I highly recommend that one. The Revolution of Ivy by Amy Engel. This was narrated on audio by Taylor Meskimen, and it is the sequel to The Book of Ivy, which came out last year, I think. I loved this book. This was the best sequel that I had read up to that point this year, and I was able to read an arc of it, although it is available on audio. The first book I read on audio. And I was so impressed with it because this author went a direction and could have really screwed this up, and she didn't. She did it really well, and 5-star book for me. I loved it, and I highly recommend it. The Until the End of the World series, this is 3.5 books by Sarah Lyons Fleming, who is a new author that I discovered this year. These books are narrated on audio by Julia Whalen, who I don't normally like, but I did for this series. And they are Until the End of the World, and then a novella called So Long, Lollipops, and then And After. And the last book is All the Stars in the Sky. This is a book about zombies. It is adult zombies, kind of along the lines of The Walking Dead. This author wasn't afraid to kill off characters and break your heart and just kill you, and then bring the whole thing around to where it was so fulfilling and so good. So I can't wait to hear what she does next, because that series was so good. November 9 by Colleen Hoover. This on audio is narrated by Zach Weber, and he is my favorite. I love him. This is a return to the style of writing that she did with her books Hopeless and Losing Hope and Finding Cinderella. I loved those stories, and I loved this one. This is all about a boy and a girl who meet, and they resolve to meet on the same day on November 9th for the next 5 years. And so it details each of those days that they meet. And really, really great characters, really interesting story. She throws in her standard plot twist about 3/4 of the way through. Always gives us a happy ending, which I love. And I think this is her best work yet. New author to me, again, was Elizabeth Hunter. And I discovered her with her Iron Chronicles. And these books are The Scribe, The Singer, and The Secret. They are a variation on the angel theme. And they are all narrated on audio by Zach Weber. These are adult paranormal romance, and they are fantastic. I have them queued up on my iPod to read again this year because they were just that good. Loved them. Loved this series and loved this author. The Snow Child by Eowyn Ivey. And this is narrated on audio by Deborah Monk. I listened to it on audio. This was recommended to me by my good friend Helene, and this is an amazing book. It is set in the 1920s in Alaska. This is actually a retelling of a Russian fairy tale. It was fabulous. The writing is very stark, very unadorned, and Deborah Monk was perfect for the narration, and I was stunned by how good it was. And I don't like books about cold and depressing kind of things. This book starts out with the woman, she decides she's going to commit suicide, and she doesn't. She stops herself at the last minute. But so I don't tend to like books like that, but this one was just stunning. I'm so glad I read it, and thank you again, Helene, for recommending it. The most recent book I read was Illuminae. This is by Jay Kristoff and Amy Kaufman. And oh my gosh, this book was fabulous. This hardback cover is amazing. This book in itself is an experience. And it's just a sci-fi story, YA. I'm listening to this book on audio right now. It's narrated by Olivia Taylor Dudley, Lincoln Hopp, Jonathan McLean. The atmosphere in the audiobook is every bit as good an experience as the print book. It's completely different, but it is every bit as good, and I am so impressed with this book, this story, these authors. Can't wait for the sequel. Another Day, this is by David Levithan, and it is the companion to Every Day. This is available on audio, although I read it as an ARC from NetGalley. It is narrated on audio by Kathleen McInerney. This is all about a being named A who inhabits a different body every day. So A is always someone different. And A is not gender specific because A is always jumping into a different gender person, a different orientation on every level. And so this is the story of the girl that A falls in love with, and it's told from her perspective, and I just loved it. Every Day is one of my favorite books of all time, and this was wonderful. Winter by Marissa Meyer. This is the conclusion to the Lunar Chronicles. It was highly anticipated. It is a big chunk of a book, which translates on audio to a whole lot of listening time, but it was so worth it. It's narrated on audio by Rebecca Solaire, and it wrapped up all of the stories of each fairy tale retelling. You had Cinderella with Cinder, and then you had Red Riding Hood with Scarlet, and then you had Cress, who is Rapunzel, and then this last book featured Winter, who is Snow White. And it was just such a great conclusion to the series. I liked the series well enough, but I loved the ending. Transcendence by Shea Savage. I read this as an ebook, and it is amazing. It is the tale of Ed, and Ed is a caveman back in prehistoric times. So he digs a pit to trap some caribou or deer or something. And then he forgets that he left his spear there, and he goes back to get it, and this modern girl is trapped in the bottom of this pit. So it is the story of their romance, and it is incredible. It is amazing because it's told from his perspective, and he has no capacity for language. The Broca's area of his brain is not developed at all. But just because he can't understand language doesn't mean that he can't understand stuff and that he doesn't feel things and know things just like a normal person would. So fascinating story, an incredible romance, and oh my gosh, I was up half the night reading it. I think I stayed up till 5 o'clock in the morning because I just couldn't put it down. I had the absolute pleasure of discovering Jill Shalvis this year. Thank you so much to Gwen at the Gwendolyn Reading Method who introduced me to Jill Shalvis. I started off with the Lucky Harbor series. I have two favorites in the series. The first is book 2, which is The Sweetest Thing, and then book 10, which is It's in His Kiss. I've since read a lot more Jill Shalvis, and she's pretty formulaic, but she always brightens my day with her stories. They're always good. The same kind of thing happens in every book, but it's so worth reading because the characters are always a little bit different. They've always got a little bit different situation and circumstance, and I love her. I'm addicted to Jill Shalvis now. And my 15th book-ish is An Ember in the Ashes by Sabaa Tahir. And I had the pleasure of meeting her at Y'all Fest in November and having her sign my book. This is a very brutal, brutal story about a world very similar to the Roman Empire. I listened to it on audio. It's narrated by Fiona Hardingham and Steve West, and they are two Brits, and they are fantastic. Fantastic. Really fantastic narration. So I'm looking forward to reading the sequel, which comes out later this year. Should be really good. So those are my 15 books, sort of, that I read in 2015 that were real huge standouts. I am very pleased with 2015. I'm looking forward to an amazing 2016 because there are just so many good books that are coming out and so many books that I haven't even read yet that already are out. So if you've read any of those books, if you have any feelings about any of them, if any of them were one of your favorites for 2015, let's talk about that. Of course, I want to hear what your thoughts are. So let's talk about that in comments. And that's it for now for me. I will see you next time. Thanks for watching. You're gonna miss me when I'm gone. You're gonna miss me by my walk. You're gonna miss me by my talk. Oh, you're gonna miss me when I'm gone.